But first tonight, a 13-year-old boy is in a serious condition in hospital after being hit by an out-of-control car in Sydney's north.
10's Melinda Nusifora is at the scene at Mount Kohler. She joins us now. Mel, the boy was trapped under the car for quite some time. Just how bad are his injuries?
Kath, when you consider the extent of the crime scene here, the boy really is lucky to be alive. The out-of-control car travelled for almost 100 metres before it hit the boy head-on. Those first on the scene, though, say the boy was still conscious and talking when paramedics arrived. We are here in the front yard of one of the houses that was hit by the car, and you can just see around me the extent of the damage and the destruction and the debris here. This family say that their two girls usually play here in the front yard, and it was just sheer luck that they weren't outside at the time. A teenager's skateboard lies splintered under the wheel of this badly damaged car. The 13-year-old was pinned under the vehicle, the driver trapped inside for almost an hour.
I heard a fairly loud bang behind me, saw the little Honda come flying through past the lights, sideswiped me and continued on.
The wreckage and ruin spreads almost 100 metres down the old Pacific Highway. The car took out a guardrail before hitting Richard Closier's four-wheel drive. It crossed a car park, crashed through a fence and into the backyard of a neighbouring home.
Just ago, I just heard a huge bang, but we didn't know it was so close. It just sounded like timber breaking.
It then sped across this street and into another house. It's believed the teenager was skateboarding on the footpath when he was hit.
The paramedics arrived on scene and treated the 13-year-old male with chest and pelvic and lower limb injuries.
The boy was airlifted to Westmead Children's Hospital, where he's in a serious but stable condition. The driver was rushed to the Royal North Shore Hospital with head injuries.
All we could do was get them out. Obviously, they'd been through a pretty heavy ordeal.
Onlookers estimate the car was travelling at least 80 kilometres an hour. Witnesses say the driver had a blank expression on his face and didn't attempt to brake. There is the suggestion he may have suffered a seizure or a heart attack. Authorities say it's lucky no one else was hurt. The car ploughed into children's play equipment in the backyard of one of the houses.
A couple of minutes later and it could have been me on the other side of the car.
Melinda Nusifora, 10 News.